You guys, I had planned to read for Mother's Day, Mother Like Daughter Story, and I'm gonna try to get through this video and not get too choked up and read one of the Mother Daughter stories for you. But first, I think I have my own story that's gonna choke me up. Just a sweet story that I want to share. In case I get too choked up, I might not be able to read the mother-daughter story. But anyways, let me tell you what happened. And it's not that... this hasn't happened to any of you guys before. I'm sure that it has. And if it hasn't yet, if your children are still below the age of 30, maybe you need to wait till they get into their 30s for this to happen. But let me tell you what happened. You know, the other day I posted my little gifts from Mother's Day. We kind of had Mother's Day on Saturday. Our big Mother's Day was on Saturday. I knew my daughters would be coming over, but it was more just to spend time with us. You know, not, it wasn't like the traditional giving of gifts on Mother's Day, because we kind of had done it on Saturday at my mom's house, grandma's house, and the siblings, people from out of town. So we kind of ended up having two Mother's Days. But anyways, so the one thing I knew about was my one daughter was going to get us a big breakfast for Mother's Day. And my first choice is McDonald's. So go to McDonald's and get me and my husband the huge deluxe breakfast with the coffee. So that was pretty much all I was expecting. And of course coffee. I love McDonald's coffee. So she did that. Little creamers on hand, because so many times I run out of cream, or for whatever reason, sometimes I like to throw them in my purse if I know I'm going to go somewhere or be at somebody's house and they don't have coffee, liquid coffee creamer. They either have like milk or powdered creamer, but she always asks, and this just got me. This is like a little added extra sugar sweet touch to remind me that how intimately she knows my little things. I'm gonna start crying. And she did mention that since it was gonna be so nice, that, you know, she mentioned kind of plants and she mentioned a barbecue. What I did not expect, this was from both of my daughters, and I thought the gift giving was over. I thought it was all done. Look at this beautiful, I guess these are orchids. They're beautiful. They're live. Flowers are live. Something beautiful. So I wore this all day yesterday, like a Hawaiian lei. Just beautiful. So the sunglasses, so both daughters donated. I have on loan 6 pair of sunglasses from my one daughter, who's more like my husband, and 1 pair of sunglasses from my adult daughter, who's more like me. This is kind of cute. I'm going to show you this. Look, these sunglasses. Do that. And then So I thought that was really sweet that they remembered I was on going on a sun kick with my sunglasses. So then my one daughter mentioned, yeah, I'm going to try to. So I think she's just going to go to Vaughn's or Smart and Final and pick up a little ring. She ends up going to Costco and buys two huge tri-tips at like the best price ever. We inhaled them. She did an awesome barbecue for me and my husband and both my daughters and one boyfriend. And she had everything cooked and just all ready for us to eat. Like in no time, it was like amazing. I mean, before I knew it, she had everything just perfect. Then, my other daughter, they set the table outside like a nice picnic table on the patio. She had this beautiful flower arrangement. I don't know if you guys can see it. These yellow, beautiful yellow flowers and this totally cute baby blue vase had this outside on a huge white tablecloth. This in the middle of the flowers. Then, and she also got a watermelon. This all happened. I still cannot believe how this all happened, how she got in the house from Costco. But she did mention the best time to go to Costco was on Mother's Day. There was hardly nobody there, so she got a lot done. Got the car washed, filled the car up with gas. It was the best surprise ever. She also got a huge watermelon, and watermelon was sliced, tri-tip was cooked, and there was more gifts, and I got my little devotional book. She knows I love the little Sarah Young devotional book. She got my little Sarah Young devotional book. She had noticed my kitchen towels were all old and dilapidated, and she knows I like these dark colors. She shows up with these awesome kitchen towels from Costco. Somebody threw in this nice little delicious thing of tea from Hardy and Sons. They have the best tea ever. This showed up. It was like all these little surprises. Oh, and here's another perfect little gift. I'm pretty sure she got these at Costco. I'm almost positive. Stamps. Postage stamps. She knows I'm always flustered. Never have postage stamps. Oh, how are them? Just so sweet. And for so long. You really do need to have, like when you do your laundry, it really is important to put delicate clothing and undergarments in a special bag. So my one daughter got me these. Oh, brand new. And I was going to give one to the other daughter. I kind of forgot. But these little lingerie clothing bags are awesome. If you guys want to keep your delicate lingerie and delicate items that you wash, if you want to keep them nice, these bags are awesome. I'm going to get one to my daughter. Remember the Kirkland baby wipe? She got a huge old box, like a 9 jumbo thing of baby wipe. I use these everywhere in the car. I have them on the counter. I have them like in every room of the house. These are like good for, I use the Kirkland ones for like industrial doorknob, and then I use the huggy the baby wants for hands and stuff. She comes home from Costco going, "Here, Mom, here, Mom." I was so touched. And she comes home with a huge jumbo package of paper towels. I'll have paper towels for her. I didn't ask for a single thing. She just, when she was at Costco, she was doing something there. Oh, I did ask for half and half cream, that's right. I didn't know she did the McDonald's thing, but she went in there to get dry dip and my half and half cream, and then I guess she went in a tailspin. Then, you guys know, she came home with three of these, three two-packs, because she knows we love it and we go through it so fast. How sweet is that? And a huge jumbo thing of toilet paper, man. There's you. I have this forever. And then when I tried to pay her, some of it or part of it, she wouldn't let me pay her. And she also had, as kind of a nice surprise, she had two. Is this a tomato? No. Oh, a cucumber and two tomato plants. We planted the tomato plants already. And an artichoke. She came home with four little vegetable plants that we'd been talking about, and I couldn't, she wouldn't let me pay her for anything. And then I find out she's just like her father. She just takes care of us whenever she can. And she had noticed that the speaker system she had gotten us from Costco wasn't working perfectly. I didn't know it had a problem. We didn't know it had a problem. We thought it was fine. We listened to it on the big screen TV. We felt like we were in the movie theater. She takes the whole thing apart, takes it to Costco to get us something better, something new. So when I tried to pay her, well, let me pay her. She said, "Well, I used the money from your sound system." I said, "What?" I said, "What happened?" She said, "Well, I'm getting you a new one." So we kept going round and round, but I kept trying to pay her, and she wouldn't let me pay her. But is that just like the best Mother's Day gift you could have? The fact that she even knew that sound system was kind of offbeat, I don't know exactly, but it meant that much to her to make sure it was working, like perfect. So I guess that's like the Father's Day gift coming up. She's working on that. I think for Father's Day. So look at all these. It says Kirkland. These are all Kirkland. And she gets the kind of good sunglasses. Not my style, but I'm going to do another sunglasses video eventually. And so my sweetheart had gotten me a car. Wonderful, what, and the card, I did so much, sobbing happy tears yesterday, when I really thought that so much of my Mother's Day was over. So just a word of encouragement to your moms out there, maybe your kids in high school or college, and do you think they you or you're wondering, did I do a good job? Something happens to them when they get to be in their 30s. So, just keep encouraged. I know what a blessing you're.